All right. Hi, everybody. This room is really crowded. Last research thing I came to, there were about three or four students. So I'm super excited to see everybody here. I'm from internal medicine and primary care. My name is Lydia Bonanno, and I trained in internal medicine, and I also trained in epidemiology. So I have a PhD in epidemiology from Tulane. I'm a local. I also did my medical degree at Tulane. And I went to do my residency at Beth Israel Deaconess Hospital. I came back down right before Katrina. Then Katrina hit, but I had lots of fun. We redid our house, and we traveled around, etc. But to tell you a little bit more about my research, I do cardiovascular disease research primarily, and also research in vascular disease risk factors. Sorry, I'm going to get this off my collar. Everybody can hear me, right? Okay, so there are a lot of vascular disease risk factors. Obesity is one of them. I don't know if y'all know small birth weight is a vascular disease risk factor. So there's a developmental origins of disease concept in which small birth weight is a risk factor for diabetes. It's a risk factor for kidney disease. So there are all sorts of things that are risk factors for vascular diseases. It's quite an interesting field. There's a lot of resources in that area too, and I can also introduce you to some resources that might be helpful for you in research in general. So because I've worked at Tulane and I also work at the School of Public Health there, and I have a background in epidemiology and statistics, it can be hard at times to develop methods and also to know exactly what you're doing when you're doing research in populations or in even in the hospital, abstracting data, etc. How many of y'all have a good footing in biostatistics? Raise your hand if you feel comfortable. Yeah, that's right. Okay, good. That's great. That's good. You know, so lots of folks don't feel like they have a good handle on that, you know. And even if you do feel like you have a good handle on that, there are probably some finer points that you could use assistance with. And while there are a lot of resources here, sometimes a little bit more one-on-one help can be appreciated too. So while there's a lot of ways that you can get help, I can also help to buddy you up with an MPH student. They have to do 200-hour practicums for their work in the School of Public Health at Tulane. So they're often looking for projects with data. They have to do it outside of Tulane. So that's one way that it may be that I may be helpful to you. And again, I just wanted to also mention that the internal medicine is a really broad field. So again, vascular disease risk factors are also a really broad field. Questions, though. What do you guys have questions about? Nothing. Okay. All right. Meta-analysis. Anybody know what that is? Okay. Wait, there's a question in the back there. Go for it. No? Okay. All right.
Yes, if you know what meta-analysis is.
Oh, great. All right. I'm glad you know what that is. No, but I mean, meta-analysis is a good thing to know about. So that's actually something that you don't have to collect your own primary data to do. You can collect data from the literature that exists already, and it's something that gets quoted a lot if you actually publish meta-analysis. I think the battery ran out. But if you actually publish a meta-analysis, it gets quoted a lot, probably, because it's something that can it can combine data from a variety of different studies. Usually it's randomized controlled trials, but sometimes it can be observational studies. So this is something that is relatively simple to do. Now I'm saying relatively simple, you know, it's relative. It's all relative there, but it can be done. And I've helped a lot of people do it over the course of the years. Another kind of simpler way to get into something that could be publishable is to do clinical or systematic reviews, and systematic reviews of clinical, thank you, of clinical, not case series, although clinical case series are good, clinical recommendations, though, because there are a variety of different clinical recommendations, right? So, aspirin guidelines. Where do aspirin guidelines come from? give me one society that's going to give you aspirin guidelines. Any society. Great, the American Heart Association. Okay, so like internal medicine, I would say. So the American Society for, the ACP, the American, ACP will give you internal medicine guidelines. A whole bunch of different places will give you internal medicine guidelines. I mean, so aspirin guidelines will also come from those as well, and they'll also come from Heart Association. They'll come from a whole bunch of different places, and they can conflict, right? So European societies are going to give you guidelines. American societies are going to give you guidelines. What do you do when those guidelines conflict? What do you do if you're a clinician and those guidelines conflict? You go with the American one, okay. Well, what if there are multiple American ones? What do you do for prostate cancer, you know? I mean, do you do the DRE? What about the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force guidelines? All right, so it's okay if you're not there yet. That's totally fine.
But you look at most recent.
Most recent is good.
Most recent data.
Okay.
Sorry.
All right. Largest samples.
You want to look at the quality. Yeah, you want to look
quality.
At the data that's supporting the guidelines.
All right. Yes, all of these are good ideas.
You evaluate the underlying research and how well it's cited in your recommendation.
Excellent. All right. Is that a good way to get published and maybe make it a useful contribution? Yeah. Is it a good way to get quoted too and get into the residency of your desires? Yeah. All right. Well, I think I've said what I was saying.
Lydia, can you just tell me some of the opportunities to present there for internal medicine?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So ACP has local and national presentations, and that's fabulous. There's also this, the SGIM regionals. There's a regional conference, and they come from... Also, with ACP, it's regional. Everybody comes from, you know, Alabama to Tennessee. They come from all over. And then there's the national one. So if you present at the regional and your presentation is good enough, they send you to the national. And there are funds to do all this. And you're actually expected to do it later on in your residencies as well. And then American Heart Association, you know, if you're in the vascular area, and then the Infectious Disease Society, IDSA, is often here. So New Orleans is a great place because we have a giant convention center and people, you know, all of the different societies of the medical specialties of your dreams, they will be here at some point in time. So, yeah, you can impress. You can do it.